Hi guys and welcome back to the channel. And we finally have the Project Cars 3 with us on the PS4. A lot has already been said about the game, as you would have seen on the YouTube. Let's try to find out here how much of that negative talk is actually true and if the game is worth your money on the PS4. In the background, I'll be having the initial gameplay of the game and a career mode race. I'll be giving you my opinion about the game, and it may or may not be what you want to hear. So let's see which one it is. And also, if you like the video and agree with what I say, please give this video a like and subscribe to the channel.
Revolution needs a new breed of driver, and this is where you come in. We need bravery, determination, and willingness to take the risks needed to win. So let's get you out on the track and see what you can do.
So the game begins by straight away putting you into a race, and I think this is the new Corvette C8. It's a good looking car, and it's nice to see some new cars also in the game. More or less, the overall car collection in the game is quite similar to Project Cars 2. However, there are some new cars as well in the game. And straight away, I would like to begin with that this is a game. It's not a simulation. It's not a sim racing game. I wouldn't exactly call it a sim arcade game as well. This, in my opinion, is a normal racing game. That's it. The ones we have grown up playing, like Need for Speed Most Wanted, Need for Speed Shift, and the Drive Club, which was there on the PS4. Even though initially people thought that this is going to be another step up from the Project Cars 2, where it will be more immersive and it will have a good sim experience. But I think they have gone in a completely different direction, and I appreciate them for this. Right now, majority of the racing games that you find tend to incline towards that sim experience. And almost every game wants to have some simulation aspect in their gameplay, and that appeals to a larger demographic of the racers out there right now. But what they forget is that there are also those people who do not want to play the simulation games, and they just want to play some racing games without being too serious about it, as we used to do when we used to play the Need for Speed games. Or Burnout Paradise, if you guys remember. I really loved that game. If it were to launch today, would the same people say that that's not a real representation of how a car drives or how the physics is? Because that game wasn't about physics at all. It was just about driving and crashing your opponents, and it was great fun. So this game has gone into that direction where it appeals to almost everyone out there playing games. Should they have named this something else? Probably yes. Something like Project Racing or something. And I think it's the naming that is troubling most of the people out there. I don't blame them for the direction of the game where they have taken it. But yes, they could have named it something else. One of the main issues that people had with Project Cars 2 was that it was not enjoyable on the controller. And it was because it was mainly targeted towards that sim experience, so you needed a wheel and pedals for that. And that can be quite costly as well. But playing with a controller is comparatively cheaper and easier. And according to me, this game has a better handling on the controller than on the wheel. Because the basic handling of the game is like an arcade game, on the wheel it's not that enjoyable as it is on the pad. You can still have good fun with the wheel and pedals. So here with this game, they're targeting the people who do not want to play a simulation game and be too worried about how efficient they have to be with the controls. Here this game is more like a plug and play, where the learning curve is not that steep. Though the game does provide you with the option of turning off all the assists and having somewhat closer experience to a sim, but it's not quite similar. the game does has a better suspension model, but there's no tire wear. The overall grip of the tires in the game is too much, in my opinion. The braking distances in the game is way shorter than what you find in other games. Also, there is damage in the game, but it's only visual. It does not affect in the performance of the car in any way. So they've gone with the whole arcade experience with this. So how do the cars handle in this game? Well, the cars have different handling characteristics in the game as compared to a normal arcade game. So a road car does behave differently than a GT car. And the GT cars are much more enjoyable in my opinion in this game than the road cars. One good thing about the game is that it has an exhaustive career mode. You start with road E cars and then make your way up. So there is a lot more to do in the career mode than in the previous versions. The biggest positive for the game, I think, is the online mode. They have a really good structure here for the online. They have the daily, weekly and monthly challenges in the rivals section. In the multiplayer, they have the quick play where it joins you into a random server. They have these scheduled events, 6 in total that you can access at any time, and they are 20 minutes apart. And then there's the custom lobby where you can create your own sessions. Now let's come to the points that I don't like about the game. What I don't like is that the force feedback on the wheel is not that great. What I found was that the default force feedback setting provided by the game is more than enough, as the car control is not that precise. You have to still manage the GT cars, but the overall information provided by the game is not that much. So when the car is going over the curbs, you can see the screen shaking, but there's no feedback on the wheel. There is some vibration that comes when you go off the track, but that's about it. And the biggest flaw in the game that I feel are the graphics. The graphics on the PS4 version is not good. It's like somewhere in between Crew 2 and NFS Heat. The reflections are not proper. There is anti-aliasing problem, and I really hope that they fix the graphics issue with an update. And I think it is fixable. The graphics are good, but they could have been better. And surprisingly, well, not surprisingly, but the PC version has good graphics. The developers really need to come up with an update for the graphics, otherwise they're going to lose out a lot on the console versions. But it's not something that will take the fun away from the game. The overall enjoyment that you get driving different cars and all of the different tracks in the game is still pretty good. And it's something that is fixable, so I don't think it should be a deal breaker by any means. So finally, to the end of the video, and to sum it up, is it worth your money? Well, on the PC, yes, it is worth your money. You will have a good time playing it, and it does fill in that gap that was beginning to form of not having a good arcade racing game, where it is basic in its approach, but also quite sophisticated enough. For the PS4, if you are someone who is looking for an arcade racing game where you don't want to be bothered about hitting someone else, or you are not that comfortable playing a proper same game like Assetto Corsa or Gran Turismo Sport, you can go for this game. This does bridge that gap, and it is better than Need for Speed Shift, where you have a linear storyline, and if you don't want something like that, here you can just do races, compete in the career mode, and the online structure is good. Also, the online races will be good, so no one will blame you for punting like in the Gran Turismo. But if graphics are your main judgment criteria, then I don't think this game is for you right now. Maybe you can wait till an update comes and the game becomes a bit better. If you remember, Gran Turismo Sport initially came out with way less tracks and cars, and eventually they added all these cars that we have right now and all the different tracks. Also, the driving physics was changed, I think, almost 1 to 1.5 years ago. So who knows what updates we have in store for this game. So if you don't want a serious game and just want to have fun with a racing game, then this game is for you. However, the graphics are not going to impress you. Maybe with an update it gets fixed, but that's something that you'll have to keep your fingers crossed on. But if you're looking for that sim experience, then no, this game is not for you. Maybe you are better off with the Gran Turismo Sport or the Assetto Corsa series. So you have to make that decision for yourself on the PS4, whether you can live with the graphics. They are not all bad, as you can see from the gameplay video here. I know the video is in 720p, unfortunately. I really apologize for that. The graphics are really not that bad. They are playable, but nothing compared to Gran Turismo Sport. So that's it from me then in this video. I will be coming up with more videos for Project Cars 3, where I will be going into details about the various aspects of the game. And I hope you like the video and appreciate the content. And thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next one.